Marvel news. I've got Black Panther 2 updates for you. Me and Larry know who the villain is going to be. Chadwick Boseman is going to come back. But first, before we dive into how we know, let me give you guys the clip from a past movie that was the first inkling of who was going to be the villain in Black Panther 2. DJ, you know, roll that track.
A reading on those tremors?
It was a mild subduction under the African plate.
Do we have a visual? How are we handling it?
Net. It's an earthquake under the ocean. We handle it by not handling it.
So what we're seeing, ladies and gentlemen, is different people who have worked on the movie basically are telling you that Namor is going to be the villain in Black Panther 2. That was a lead up we've seen in the beginning. This right here where they're focusing in on the map was another lead. And this is Kevin Feige discussing it before Black Panther dropped. And as you can see right there under that second section, it talked about Namor being the villain. And in terms of Chadwick Boseman, this is just a showing of him when he was practicing for Black Panther. Him losing weight is not a big deal. I mean, my man is already tiny. I mean, dude could afford to eat 25 different Oreos and still wouldn't be any bigger than me or Larry. So the rumors about him not coming back, they're just rumors. He's not a big guy in the first place. And the way that they're going to probably introduce Namor and why they're talking about the earthquake underwater, that basically was happening around the time after the Thanos snap. That's the reason for that earthquake. And so the issue with Wakanda in the first place is they're isolationist nation. They don't believe in getting in anybody's affairs. They don't believe in helping anybody. They don't want to help anybody. So what they're rumoring the plot is going to be is that Namor is going to come attack Wakanda because they didn't come help him during the snap. He didn't know what the hell was going on. People were getting the hell up out of the ocean left and right, and no Wakanda in sight to help. So he's going to rage war on Wakanda out of fury from the snap. Larry, are you excited for Namor versus Black Panther, one of the most iconic storylines in comics? And by the way, Namor technically is the first mutant for Marvel. He came out before the X-Men did.
Wow, I didn't realize that.
Mm-hmm.
So let me ask, I have to ask everyone, if you were about to go to war, if you were in Wakanda and you were about to go to war, who do you want as your leader? Do you want T'Challa? Or do you want the rightful ruler of Wakanda, Killmonger?
Oh, hear this
That's
guy
all
go,
I'm saying.
Man.
This guy won't let That's it go.
Man, let it go, man.
Who do you want, the rightful ruler who is a straight-up beast? Or do you want this little thin, I can't decide if I'm in love or not in love, little T'Challa dude getting thrown over waterfalls? Come on, man.
Man. And Larry, and what happened to Killmonger's ass in the second fight?
Man, Black Panther cheated anyway.
How did he cheat?
He cheated because he was talking about, come on, let's finish this. Let's finish this challenge. Well, the challenge isn't supposed to be fought when you have the power of the Black Panther. You're supposed to fight it as regular humans. He cheated again.
How did he cheat when Killmonger had the powers of the Black Panther when he came back? Uh-oh, ladies and gentlemen, we have a T-Stream sighted.
What's going on, man?
T-Stream in the house.
Sorry, man, I'm a little tardy. My son got off work a little early today, so I had to actually pick him up at 9, and I didn't know till 9.
Hey, you good, brother? We know who the villain is going to be in Black Panther. Chadwick Boseman is coming back to play Black Panther. And Larry's over here trying to still fool the people into thinking Killmonger is really the king of Wakanda. If Killmonger was the real king, Namor would really come and whip their ass for real, because in the comics, he can't stand Killmonger. I say he can't stand him. He can't stand him. And Killmonger really wouldn't have went down there to help him. It would have been ugly. But T-Streams, tell us what you think about Namor being the villain in Black Panther and our boy coming back.
Man, well, I tell you first thing, I think Marvel and Disney did a very wise job by bringing Chadwick back. Had they not, me personally, I probably would have lost all interest in the film like I once had it. But I'm glad to see that he's coming back. Namor as the villain, I think it'd add a twist. I want to see how they flip it, and I'm sure they'll make it interesting. Who are they saying actually playing him?
They haven't said no, but this particular movie is still one of the only movies that is still stayed to its schedule. It's coming out May 2022.
Okay. Well, I would hope so. You know, that's a little bit. I told you they didn't push some of these movies so far back, like 2021, not going to make it or something. I don't know.
I just hope whoever plays Namor is a real, like, a big dude. Don't make him some little tiny dude they try and bulk up. Just make him a big dude.
Yeah.
Forget it.
Yeah, that's one of the things that they have to get right. If they're going to, you know, if they're going to use him, they have to have somebody that's, you know, that can pull the character off pretty good, you know.
Mm-hmm. I would rather you get an Asian Pacific looking dude who fits the character than to go get someone as big as The Rock or something like that. You know, yeah. I would just rather see that, because either way, I got complete confidence in Ryan Coogler to do this movie. Complete.
The Rock wouldn't actually be bad for that role. I mean, it's frustrating I get by him not playing black characters sometimes.
Well, you know what?
Good one for him.
I don't know if they. I don't think they can do that, because The Rock is trying to be Black Adam, who kind of resembles the depictions of Namor a little bit. But we'll just have to see about that.
Yeah.
Right. So.